It used to be a military base. Well, it used to be a ranching thing, then it was turned into an army thing, then it became a bird thing and a museum or whatever. Henry Fonda stationed here, I think, for a bit. Unless he was Navy.
Who's Henry Fonda?
Around Christmas time, this little breakfast place used to sell these amazing polar bear sugar cookies. Man, those were good. And then one year they changed the formula or whatever and ruined it. Alex? Hey, still with us? You haven't said anything for like 10 minutes. Mission control to Alex.
Yeah, my mind drifted for a second.
So you all moved in?
Not really. I just got in this morning.
And how did her mom meet your dad exactly?
They met on vacation in Orlando. He got lost in a... You know, actually, I'm not even gonna tell this story. It's really not worth it.
Okay.
Yes, please don't. Let's not relive their meet cute any more than we have to.
And you guys just met tonight?
Yeah, I was, I'd been out of school, and the timing had just never worked out, so...
And what does that make you to her, then? A, second cousin? I don't know how people math work.
It'll be like a roommate, really.
No, but isn't there, like, a term for it?
Step-brother, technically.
Oh, yeah. I forgot that was even a thing. Well, at least you seem cool, right? Cool guy, cool hat. You get a cool new sibling, living right in your house. Sharing your toothbrush. Wearing your clothes. Eating your food.
No, that's the weird part. I mean, isn't it like... The concept of just getting a new sister like a puppy, isn't it kind of awkward?
No, it's been totally bizarre. But just for the record, I don't consider you a pet. So, how do you two know each other?
Oh, from way back when, like Paleozoic, grade school era. Young enough that I've seen her in a bathtub and it wasn't sexual at all. I mean, we both looked like little skinned potato blobs. And to date, that's still what I think she looks like under her clothes.
Passengers, we'll be arriving soon.
Check under your seat to make sure you don't leave behind any grandchildren.
Oh, we should get a quick picture. All of us. This'll be like the before shot. They're on their way.
Fine, just hold the camera out, like, far. I don't look my freshest right now.
It's true, Jonas. This is like B minus Alex. Just for your calibration. And it's Jonas, not Jonah.
Yeah, Jonas. Like Jonas Salk?
Right, patient zero, AIDS guy.
It's, biblical, right? Or is that the lion guy?
I think every name's biblical, so probably.
Here's good. There, great. I'll magic erase all the warts out and stuff, so don't worry. Hey, Alex, you brought the radio, right? The little portable one?
What radio?
That little, you know, the little, it almost looks like a toy, oh, you're joking. Just bring it out, will you? There's the little guy. Our high school has a radio station, and Carly, she's a friend of ours. She's filling in because Reggie got mono from some track runner or something. It doesn't matter. What matters is that she's gonna say something like, basically, right now, about our thing, so tune it to 88.3 so I can tell her we heard it.
Which I played because that song's been stuck in my head since I woke up this morning. But, oh, actually, it's a little after 10 o'clock, which means my dear friend Ren and his buddies are probably just touching down on Edwards Island for the yearly bash on the beach, or whatever we call it now. But anyways, I promised him that I'd play a song from his band, so hope you're listening, Ren. Here are the Red-Headed Bedwetters with Baby Carrots.
That's awesome. I hope Christina, with her talent show judge face, was listening. We must be getting close. There's no radio reception on the island. I'm glad I got to hear it before it went totally kaput.
If we can't use it, why'd you bring it? Not just for the boat.
No. You'll see. I don't expect too much, but nah, it'll be fun. I won't undercook it. You'll see. Smell that clean air, boys and girls. Boy and girl, this ain't city living.
Yeah, anybody need a smoke? I have a full pack.
No thanks. I mean, I literally just said the clean air thing, so...
Alex, you can bum one off me if you're empty.
No thanks. I don't smoke. Last time I had one, it didn't go well.
Yeah, no, I didn't know what coughing with your whole body meant until I saw you dry heaving.
Okay, just checking.
All right, my other friend should be up and around the bend.
Actually, I don't mean to be the guy to break us up already, but Ren, can you do me a favor? Can I have like 2 real quick minutes with Alex for a second? And you can run up and meet your friends?
Really? Just...
Wait, is something wrong? What is it?
Nothing's wrong, nothing's wrong. It'll just take 2 minutes, super fast.
All right, bud. look, I don't want to go up by myself. I mean, can't we just stick together? You're gonna have all night to say, like, whatever.
But since you want to meet up with your friends anyway...
We're all gonna meet up with them.
No, it's fine, Ren. Go on up ahead and we'll catch up with you.
Okay, I guess. Though this is a really strange way to start off, splitting up.
It'll be fast. Thanks, man.
I'll just be up the hill, in case... whatever.
Ren seems nice. He's funny, you know?
Yeah, he's... Look, just what did you want to talk to me about before I suspect something nefarious?
No, it's nothing. It's not bad. Listen, I just wanted to grab you ahead of time and say you've been cool about everything. And I guess it's just for me, I've never moved anywhere. And like getting a new family at the same time kind of feels like I'm skipping the training wheels. Not that it's been bad or anything. You and your mom have been great.
Well, how do you think I feel? My house just shrunk by half because my mom decided to get some in Florida.
No, I know. I'm sorry. Oh, and thanks for setting up the attic for me. It's cool how it's like a little bedroom. I was in the basement at my old house, so...
Well, we didn't actually set it up for you.
Oh, crap. That was Michael's room, right? Oh, man, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to bring it up.
Let's just change the subject.
No, absolutely.
I heard about your mom. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you know... What are you gonna do? We can catch back up with Ren now. I didn't mean to take so long.
Block this off at night since nobody needs to use it? Or maybe they just had a parade?
Sure. Either one.
It's kind of kitschy. Right? It's kind of kitschy?
Yeah, it's like a quiche.
If nobody lives here and the stores are all closed... Whose car is this?
Oh, there's always that one lonely car in every parking lot.
Ah, I forgot this was even here. It's a monument to some submarine that was sunk off the coast.
Oh, do the radio guide thing they talked about on the boat, you know? It's what, like 102.3?
Okay, sure.
I think they said it's one of...
Named after the Hawaiian god of the sea, the USS Kanaloa was launched on January 15th, 1941, and commissioned into service at the end of that year.
I've never heard of this before. Kind of creepy in a way, right?
On October 28th, 1943. Hell.
Yeah, my dad had a bunch of comics named that from like the 70s, but it was like literally Marines fighting Satan or dinosaurs or something.
Submarine casualty in America. Named after the Hawaiian god of the sea, the USS...
Parks and Facilities Office. Ren's sister Allison used to work there. You'd like her. She's tall.
All right.
close up early.
I guess no point in staying open if nobody's here.
That's true.
Hello, kids. Look, the other guys and gals must be further up, so be quick now. Okay, speed read definition of Edwards Island. This is a tourist trap with shops and a beach. Nobody lives here except for some geriatric named Mrs. Adler. But, as God is my witness, we'll never mention her or any other old person's name again. We are here to drink and be stupid, a tradition apparently started by bored recruits in the 1950s who would sneak dates over from the coastal towns. They literally called it trawling.
Really? That's kind of gross.
Yeah, sex is gross. So disgusting. Man, get a room, you soldiers. So, to summarize, we are not allowed here after dark. The town is shut down, and we, the Kamina High junior class, have come to commit improper acts. And the other thing is the weirdo caves.
Weirdo caves?
The whole reason Alex brought her radio is because when you go to the... It's like the front.
The mouth?
The mouth of this particular cave, you can sometimes pick up frequencies to stations that don't exist. You'll hear voices or just sounds. And they're...
It's pretty creepy. At least I've heard.
I did it once. It's amazing when it works.
So, back up a second. Who's Mrs. Adler?
Her family, I think, like, owns some of the island or something. She's been shacked in the same spot for, like, 70 years. She's kind of what you call the local legend. She has a house...
I can't imagine living in the same exact house, looking at the same exact walls for that long a time.
Well, it takes a certain someone. And actually, you know what? Speaking of the opposite of those certain someones, the beaten path officially ends here. The beach is past the fence. I think Jerry told me that there's a way that it used to get over... there, but I'm blanking on what it was. But it's not, I mean, it can't be too difficult.
Well, look, there must be something. I mean, Jerry got over.
Yeah, exactly. Jonas, did you know...
I think the dumpster will get us over if it'll budge.
Well, let's try it.
So, anyways, is it true or not? Are you not staying for college?
And did this little birdie tell everyone he did Susie Lyons even though it was only over the pants stuff? Just because Mark spends his study hall at the advisory board doesn't mean he's allowed to look through our submissions.
Look, Alex, if you are thinking of leaving, I just hope you're doing it for the right reasons. That's all. That's my whole spiel.
Rent, why do you even care about this?
Oh, I don't know, maybe because you're my friend, and I'll miss you if you go. That's what a friend does. They miss the other person, and I don't want you to regret anything. Before we get there, I should probably mention that...
Oh, God.
Who's that?
There's this girl, Nona. She's just this girl, and I'm totally into her, and I want her to be into me, so just, you know, just be cool, okay? No pouting or complaining or anything, all right?
Why wouldn't I?
Don't be like, just how you can be sometimes. Oh, and okay, Jonas, now that we're dumpster buddies, what was the thing that you said to Alex back there? Do you have one of those vestigial tales or something?
Reginald, I hear you over there.
Hey, guys.
Wait, I was about to tell a story. What was it?
About Brad's car.
Oh, well, that can wait.
Hey.
We started a fire down the way, but Nona wanted to play beach nanny, so...
Yeah. Hi.
Hi.
And Jonas, that's...
Who are you?
Jonas.
That's Jonas. He's Alex's new in town, fresh as a daisy stepbrother.
Stepbrother?
Really?
Yeah, I know. It's a trip, right?
Yeah, this is his first night here, so everybody be on your best behavior. Treat him as you would a scary dog. Palms out.
I don't bite. It's fine.
Wait. You're Jonas. Jonas, the stepbrother.
Yeah. What's your name again?
That is Clarissa.
How are you her stepbrother? Like, what does that even mean?
My mom married his dad, so family law and all.
Yeah, well, I guess this is happening now. This is a thing that is happening, so... Where's everyone else?
Nicole had that tennis thing.
And?
Who else was supposed to come?
Anyone? Everyone?
Clarissa, we... we took the last ferry. I thought more would show up, but...
Oh my god, it's just Alex and her new stepbrother? Huh, that's it. That's who you brought. That's the group.
Clarissa, seriously, who even invited you?
I did.
Ren invited Nona, and Nona invited me. Though, begged me would maybe be the better way to put it.
I didn't. I didn't really beg.
Wait, aren't you all, like, friends?
I'm friends with Nona, and I'm downgrading Ren to, like, a creepy neighbor. And you, I just met.
Yeah.
Hey, what about me?
What about you?
Oh, I get it. I'm not even on the...
20 deep rager. But Pat had a party last weekend, and...
And a bunch of kids got caught TPing the school.
But this is great, right? We're on Edward's Island. Forget those losers who couldn't handle the weekend, who didn't think we could make it, who lost my invitation, who had to go
Faster.
On their... We've been hearing about this for years, and now we're gonna do it. This is gonna be amazing, right? Right, guys?
Yay! Awesomeness!
Yeah! Fire! Man's great equalizer.
So, what's the thing to do here? Other than obviously go skinny dipping and get murdered by Jason Krueger.
Yeah, let's just get drunk. It's supposed to be a party, right?
Hey, where does that old woman live?
Oh, you mean Maggie Adler?
Yeah.
Nowhere. She's dead.
What?
Yep, keeled over 3 days ago. It was all over the news. Local news, anyway. Oldest living resident.
Oh, that's sort of a bummer.
Yeah, well, we all gotta go sometime. In her case, later than sooner. And to answer your previous question, Jonas, the thing to do is lay on the beach and drink till you can't remember where you are.
And sometimes play truth or slap.
Yeah, let's play that. We can inaugurate Jonas. Ease him into the night's festivities.
Isn't it, truth or dare?
This is better than truth or dare because nobody ends up licking somebody's butthole. You get asked a question. You have to tell the truth, but if somebody can prove that you lied, the accuser gets to slap you. It's a good, getting to know somebody game.
Yeah, fun. Any excuse to hit run.
Hey, I'm the truthiest truth, whoever
All
truth,
right, let's just get on with it.
Okay, so, first, we're gonna-
I'll start. Ren.
Uh-huh.
Come on, fess up. You wanna go out with Nona, right?
Clarissa!
Wait, I wanna hear his answer.
Okay, that's... Clarissa, you know what? Ask me something instead. Anything you want.
You'll get your turn after Reginald answers the question.
Look, it's tough to gauge. Something like...
Enough stalling. I know you want to sample the goods. Now
no.
just say so.
I mean, I like her as a friend, right? I just like her as a friend. That's all. She's cool.
Oh, liar? Liar! He's lying! He totally likes her!
What? Alex, come on, what are you doing?
Tell it on him.
You told me you liked her. Why did you even try to cover... You knew I knew. I'm standing right here.
Because I asked you to be cool about it, and now you're being, like, whatever the complete opposite of cool is. Hot! But in a bad way.
All right, Alex, you get first blood. Slap him like he stole something.
I can't believe this is happening.
This really doesn't.
Hush, this is for your honor. Watch and relish.
Ha ha! And it's not even my birthday.
Yeah. Ow!
Jeez, I didn't think you had it in you.
Yeah, she's full of surprises. Backstabbing surprises.
So, Alex's turn?
Oh, great, here we go. What's your favorite stuffed animal? Professor Snodgrass, the platypus man?
Clarissa.
Oh, boy.
Yes, Mum?
This is pretty fun just watching, I'll admit.
Well, wait.
What's your worst fear?
That Santa Claus is really coming to town.
Seriously?
Dying with too many regrets, probably? I don't know.
That seems reasonable.
I kinda get that, actually.
Yeah, we're practically sisters. I can feel it.
Clarissa's turn now.
Alex, you got a new brother. Pretty exciting. I'm sure Jonas is excited, or maybe... excited isn't the right word. Maybe a little overwhelmed with just everything, you know? Unsure. It's a lot to take in and adjust to.
What's your point, Clarissa?
I'm just saying what Jonas is already thinking. That statistics show if you get divorced once, you're probably gonna get divorced again. And the fact is, your mom divorced your dad, so... let's put his mind at ease and hear why.
Just get to whatever point this is getting to.
The point is, why'd your parents get a divorce? Just so Jonas can hear it from you.
Clarissa, I don't really care why they got a divorce,
You know why. Michael died, and it broke everything, and they couldn't handle it. The end.
Well, now you know, Jonas. Don't die, and everything will be fine.
Okay, Clarissa, you...
What?
You know, guys, honestly, I think I'm pretty much ready to do anything else besides this game.
Wait, let's not stop like this. We should,
Game's over, Ren. I won. And to celebrate, I'm gonna sit on the beach and drink, and maybe, if I'm feeling spicy, even take a nap.
Maybe we could
And that's exactly what Nona's gonna do, too.
Man, what is your problem, Clarissa? Just what did I do to make you act like I ate the last piece of chocolate cake on your flippin' birthday?
Nothing, Alex. You did absolutely nothing.
Cheese!
If you guys in your scavenger hunt or playing Ring Around the Rosie, playing Starfish, you be sure to just let me know.
Super.
Sure, we'll grab ya if we find any,
Island Bigfoots?
Island Bigfoots, exactly.
Well, I want to inaugurate this bitch by checking out the caves. Nona, want to come?
I would.
I'm very clingy, Ren.
Fine. Jonas, you're a strapping young lad. Help boost me over the fence. The cave's just, yonder.
And I guess you expect me to just jump over after?
But like I said, you're a strapping young lad.
Okay, come on.
Where are you from again?
It's a small town near North Valley.
Oh yeah, is it nice?
If you like bars on the windows. Alex, you want to check out the caves, or?
Yeah, let's do it. Boost me up?
Yeah, come on. Come on, I'll push you over.
Oh, I forgot. We never
Whenever
talked about
you're
John.
Ready.
Oh, what,
so,
your date?
So, the cave. What's your bet? On a scale of 1 to 10, how weird's it gonna be?
Probably a 5. Weird enough to remember, but not weird enough to tell anybody about it after.
All right.
Hey, Clarissa seems to be her normal, annoying self. Sorry about that.
Yeah, what's her deal anyway?
I don't know. That woman's perpetually on her period.
Okay.
It's true. Kind of. Oh, and what the hell was up with you and the whole Nona thing with the game? I mean, okay, fine. Fun is fun.
It's a game called Truth or Slap, Ren. It's supposed to be a goof. I thought you'd laugh.
Why would I laugh at that? It really sucked, actually.
I'm sorry. I am. I was just trying to have fun. I didn't know you would take it so seriously.
Well, I am. I mean, I do, but it's fine. I'll just have to work the old Ren charm even stronger now.
Yeah, that'll work.
I heard that. Now, who's ready to have their minds blown?
If you don't mean that literally, I am...
Me.
Oh, wait. Actually, I almost forgot. Gonna take a little magic trip to Cupcake Town.
Those look like brownies.
Brownie Town.
Magic? What does that mean?
It means they're enhanced with certain qualities.
Well, maybe just don't eat too much.
No promises.
Delicious.
Okay, so see these little piles of rocks? The kids before us always leave them here so you know where to try and tune in the signals. So you're gonna want to stand basically right around here, and just tune the dial left or right until you start hearing some weirdness.
How will we know when it's...
Thank you.
Wow, it's even cooler than I thought it would be. This
What is it? What's doing it?
Maybe the tuning's like unblocking a weather balloon or something?
It doesn't make any sense.
Well, it's just crazy, then, because I don't know. If you move around, it kind of changes, too, I think. Like, over at this pile. Here, come over here and try it.
This is so cool.
I know!
Clarissa and Nona should see this, right? I mean, I know it's like weird with you guys or whatever for some reason, but...
They're fine where they are.
Okay, just what is Clarissa's issue with you two?
She dated Michael for 5 seconds, like 3 years ago.
It was for a couple of months a year and a half ago.
Whatever, she never liked me. Not even then. I was always the little sister who got in the way, who she had to climb in through windows to sneak around.
Clarissa's the kind of person who doesn't feel full unless she's pissed at somebody, so... Brownies are kicking in. Did that make sense?
Are you... okay?
I think so. Now, there's another cool spot, I think, over here.
It sounds so...
Yeah, it sounds...
Satanic.
Not what I was gonna say. But close enough.
Wait, what was that? There's like... This is gonna sound stupid, but there's like something in here.
Famous last words. Famous...
No, I see it too.
I'm sure there is something in there. Like... A giant rabies-filled bat, or a maniac who wears mannequin wigs.
Or it kind of looks like a pool or something. Like a freshwater one, maybe. Let's check it out. It's not that far in.
If it's a pool, that'd be cool. I, didn't mean that to rhyme.
Cool pool.
Fortune favors the bold.
Bye.
Wait a minute! Jonas!
Well, I am going to just rest against here, because I think... I think I mismeasured the magic.
I think you mean brownie.
would a guy bring an ashtray down here? Or a pen? See a man about a dog. Sure, will do. Didn't you hear me calling for you?
Jesus, you scared me.
Oh, I scared you? You scared me. I had no idea where you were.
I'm sorry for going ahead. I thought I heard somebody down here, but, you know, obviously there isn't. But isn't this place incredible? I mean, I don't even know how this happens.
No, it's beautiful.
See? That's what I heard. It sounds like a person almost, right? Kinda? I don't know where it's coming from.
Maybe it is someone. You ever think of that? Maybe it's the crazy guy who lives here and he's gonna eat out our stomachs.
Well, where is he then? In which of these tiny air holes does he hibernate? There was a light in here somewhere. I still want to see what made it. It must just be further in. Let's try and find it before we go back.
Well, seeing as how I crawled in here to get you, might as well make the most of it.
Yeah, and I mean, look, if it's cool, we can get the others, and if it's not, we'll just leave.
Like, what is this made out of? Is it ice?
I don't know. What? Wow, how is that? Did you see the floating, triangle light thing?
Yes.
It must be like a rainbow or like a reflection of light? Those, exist, right? Cave triangle rainbows?
Sure, why not? Let's go with that for the time being.
I think this is all tied to...
Apart from the, triangle, this is honestly the craziest thing in here. Like, how did it even get in? And I mean, aside from some, like, water damage, it's not really even that junky.
I know. Try your radio. Maybe that's like a frequency or something. Like if it'll have an effect.
Yeah, good idea. Maybe it'll dance or twitch or something.
Let's do it. Come on. Radio time. Alex, really, I want to see what it's gonna do. Oh my God. Is this you? Are you doing this?
Yeah.
This is insane.
Who... Are you... Who are you on the...
Listen.
Bob 2.
Shave.
2.
Sleeping. Time. Down.
Is possible.
I don't know what you mean, so I can't...
Bob 2.
Leave, children.
Bye.
See you
soon.
Alex!
Jonas!
Alex! Alex! Alex? Are you okay? You alright?
I think so. I don't know. God. Are you okay?
Yeah, I think. Look, I'm just gonna cut to the whatever. Like, I don't know exactly what happened back there, but the sign says that's an old communications tower, and I don't know about you, but I want to climb that ladder, call somebody, and get the hell back home as fast as possible. I don't want to be the party pooper here, but the
I don't know. This is kind of exciting, right?
Exciting? Alex, we don't... To think something's exciting, you kind of have to know what that something is first. And we just got crapped out of the laser light show from hell, so...
Yeah, we don't know what's going on, but it's like weird and crazy and mad. Harden Tower. Oh, it's called that, I think, because the radio man who watched it, he was Major Richard Harden. I don't know why I remember that.
Wait, the guy's name was Major Dick Harden?
Yep, it almost makes the whole trip worth it, doesn't it?
I wouldn't go that far. Oh, and not for nothing. I'm fine with a little de-pantsing or whatever if the weather's right for it. But if this is some sort of prank or trick, I'm really, really not in the mood. So...
Jonas, believe me, I wouldn't do that to you. I'm not that cruel.
Okay, well, I hope so. Just cross your fingers the comm tower has a working walkie-talkie or something.
Wait, Jonas, seriously, like, what just happened? My radio... I guess, opened something, and that something did something else.
And that something was really friggin' scary and horrible, so let's just skip to the part where we get off the island and start suppressing it in therapy.
I can see the cave, but not Ren or anybody.
What do you think happened to them?
Probably the same thing as us. Transmogrified or whatever to some other part of the island.
Great.
Locked.
Let me try.
And what exactly can you do except jiggle it more?
Oh, you'll see. What's the expression? Skills of a misspent youth?
That's not an expression.
If you want to do things the easy way, sure.
Warning, do not use aboard ship. Unsafe radiation limits.
You know, I'd normally find this stuff kinda interesting, really. You know, normally.
Yeah, well, I'm glad you find this sort of thing interesting, because I find it interminable.
You find it terminal?
Forget it. I find it boring, that's all. Is anyone there? It's, dead.
Did you get anyone?
I don't think so. Fence should be off now.
Great, but don't take offense if I want to throw a stick at it first.
Come on, don't you trust me? The light turned off.
I trust you to, like, not hurt me on purpose or anything, but, you know, if the fence kills me on accident, it's not really about trust at that point.
There's a dial tone, but there's a note here. Does not call out. Please dial station code for service.
There wouldn't happen to be a code there, would there?
Nada.
Ah! Jesus!
Oh man, whoever you are, we really need your help over here.
Alex? Alex, is that you?
Ren?
Oh, Jesus hopping Christ, thank Vishnu. You guys went into that hole and a bunch of stuff. I have no idea what happened. I just woke up like 15 minutes ago. I saw the light on in the tower thing. Hey, did you know that it's named after some guy named Dick Harden?
Ren, it's been a rough night, you know?
How'd you get this number?
It's a code written on this list here. But it's not a normal phone. I can't call out. I'm at the way station or whatever in the woods. It's been like just the worst thing ever. Just DEFCON.
How did you get all the way out there? Did you just take off sprinting when I went after Jonas?
No, like I said, I must have like passed out, or I don't know how I ended up here.
Wait, I think that's the other line. Maybe it's like a night watchman or something, or they do.
Wait, Ren, someone's calling on the other line. Just hold on a minute. I'm gonna see who it is.
Okay, but make it quick, seriously.
Hello?
Oh, Jesus Christ, Alex? Why are you answering it? It says it's an emergency line. Where are you right now?
Clarissa?
And Jonas is with you. Of course he is.
Okay, if you're gonna yell at me, goodbye, Clarissa.
Oh, really? Fine. I'm at Fort Milner with a working intercom, if you care. God, goodbye, Alex.
Ren?
Just pick me up, okay? Just come and pick me up. I'm really not great. Mike, this is not a drill. This is real world.
Alright, look, just hang tight. We're coming to get you, okay?
Good. Great. I'm by the little bridge where they tore up all the train tracks and it's just a brush or, you know. Is that the phone again? Don't click over.
Clarissa might need something.
It's Clarissa on the
other... She can wait a second. It's fine.
Look, Alex, just... Whatever you do, this is vitally important now. Heed the words. Heed these words. Just whatever you do, don't...
And it dies, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, either he dropped the phone in the toilet, or we just lost the line.
So, want to truck over to Milner first, see about that radio? I know we were going to go save Ren from his, night terrors, or whatever, but if Clarissa's found an even semi-working line to the real world, maybe that's more important right now.
I'm sure she can handle flipping the switch to talk all by herself.
Look, I'm gonna leave it up to you. We can swing through the forest and nab Ren, or we can go to the fort and see what Clarissa's up to. They're your people. You can decide.
Ren needs us more. And he'd kill me if he knew we went to see Clarissa first.
Sound logic. All right, our rescuing duties have officially commenced. Let's get this done and get off this rock like the badasses we are.
We're just gonna walk through what amounts to a park to pick up some frightened children, Jonas. Don't get ahead of yourself.
Act as if. That's all I'm gonna say. Act as if.
How are you, doing?
I'm fine, I guess. Why?
Cause everything's crazy, you know? So, just making sure your shoes are still on your feet.
They are. How are you?
Me? I'm great. I'm like a pog in its own pig. In its own filth is what I meant to say.
Good talk.